There are three types of models for success enterprise. There's a transactional model, there's the relationship model, and then there is the personalization model. Get ready for this exciting adventure. Hey, I'm Jimmy Hendrick, and this episode is called Success Enterprise on Empower Your Pattern 2.0. Did you know that there are success patterns to help you receive more, help you live a better and extraordinary life? Well, I'm Jimmy Hendrick, a Success, Confidence, and Thrive coach, a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And if you come with me, I will show you these success patterns. Let's go. Okay, we are now entering the new and improved. What can I say? New and improved. Empower Your Pattern Clubhouse. Give me a few minutes to cue something real quick. Sometimes it takes a little patience to get technology to work the way we want it to.
With canaries, you pick two. Every an athlete is an athlete, whether you're seeing.
Stupid.
Hey, Sean, train everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Hey, Sean, train everywhere we go. Hey, Sean, train everywhere we go. Everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people.
Well, here at Empower Your Pattern 2.0, we're making music for the soul today. I don't know where you guys are, but here it's a nice warm day in West Texas, almost borderline a little bit or not. What can I say? We've had quite a long winter. I'm grabbing a cold beverage. We're talking about old world and new world. How to bridge the gap. Because so many people don't know how to bridge the gap in order to have a successful enterprise. And, well, in part, I blame this crazy reactive culture for why we can't bridge the gap. Okay? And so, you're probably wondering, Jimmy, what in the world are you talking about? I'm talking about something that can make you happy. Okay? So, now that we're all together, there are three models of successful enterprise. And two that I've heard of recently on the Jeff Lerner podcast, and one I'm creating based on some research I did in my book I published about 3 years ago, The Winning Personality, A Values-Based Approach to Entrepreneurship in This Economy. I forgot. I have to get a little word from our sponsors. Empower Your Pattern through James Hendrick Empowerment. It's offering a Facebook Live. I believe it's going to be at 2 p.m. on March 26th for the Empower Your Pattern Facebook group. If you'd like to be on it, just be in contact with me. The contact information is on my website, mjameshendrick@wordpress.com. That's amjameshendrick. It's all one word, lowercase, .wordpress.com. You can also email me, if this is also all lowercase, empoweryourpattern@gmail.com. I would love to hear from you. Now, I digress. The three different models. There's the transactional, there's the relationship, And there's the personalization. And you think, what in the world about personalization? Let me explain, okay? Let me explain. This should be something that's pretty reasonable for you to begin to understand here and now. Personalization is something that is new world, but it's also from the old world that we have forgotten about. So, let's get started. Transactional. When I was a teenager, I was predominantly raised, in part as far as my values, from my maternal grandfather. He was an entrepreneur. He owned the front end of Lamas. I was sitting at his house one night watching TV, and he said, "Son, I want you to become a lawyer." I said, Granddad, ain't most lawyers miserable because they don't give enough time to their families?" He turned to me and he said, "You listen to me, boy. You don't have to be miserable if you're doing what you love. You're going to be practicing law, boy. Practice what you love. Okay?" And at the time, I was like, transactional, you know. And by transactional, the transactional model, it is, you know, immediate gratification. Well, I'm going to say it the way I said it back when I was a kid. I want you guys to sense the arrogance in the air here. Well, I'm doing the good. That's what I used to say in kicking back and playing card games and dominoes with friends, particularly friends like Brad and Jimbo. We're doing the good. Now, doesn't that sound kind of... To me, that sounds kind of immature. I mean, yes, baseline, successful enterprise is about making money. I know that, you know that, everybody that knows about entrepreneurship has to know that. Okay? But there's more than that. Yes, part of the baseline when my granddad left the workforce of fixing tires and the like for some of the big companies to form his own front-end alignment was what would do me good. But the important part, okay, this is where he really taught me. Not so much in what he said, but what he did. I think he had a couple of employees and suppliers and stuff. I would see how he would relate to those people. The relationship model. It's not just something, you know, what can I get out of you? It's like, what can I give back to you? See, some success gurus say you have to pay for a mentor. Doesn't that sound kind of immature and transactional to you? Goes back to when I was a kid. What'll do me good? Ring the bell, plain truth. Relationship bridges the gap. Here. I saw how Granddad related to his customers. I saw how he related to some of his suppliers and maybe the one or two employees that he had. And they loved him because he had integrity. They loved him because he built relationships. And I saw how he gave back to them. And how they gave back to our family. See, this business is great, okay, but it's not all about the bottom line. I remember listening to personal professional development tapes in network marketing. And they say, you know, technology and all these wonderful tools are important, but you can't replace relationship. Okay, but here's the yin-yang problem. Let's see how we are on time. Got the wrong time schedule here. Here's the yin-yang of this whole thing. so much of our reactive culture wants to pretend that it's all transaction versus relationship. It's the same thing in business, it's the same thing in marriage. Now, granted, I failed in marriage. I can't good in conscience tell you how to make a good, successful marriage. But the transactional model in marriage says 50-50. And I think the same thing in the business world, and that's why relationship, but here is the third gap. Here is the third gap. Are you guys ready? Plain truth. Personalization. You take those two, smash them together. You might say, well, Jimmy, how did you reach this determination? I want to ask you this. I want you to sit down and chew on it. How would you reach it? How would you reach it? I tell you what it was that caused me to reach it. I love the transactional. And I would love relationship. But in the business climate of the 21st century, CMOX is always cutthroat. There were some teachers that were teaching transaction, reaction, cutthroat. I walked out of those classes. The ones that's like relationship, I was like, cool. But then, February of 2015, was lacking inspiration, and I picked up this copy that I received from a friend in the March 2015 Entrepreneur Magazine, and the leading, the front, on the very cover, was talking about the winning personality. And I was chewing on that. What is this winning personality? What is personalization? Yes, there's a transaction. There's the bottom line. Yes, there's a relationship. But personalization? Is where you take the values of old world and new world and smash them together. Like you're crushing the ice. It's just freshly in there. It's like in a bottle of ice water to drink and enjoy on a nice warm spring day such as this. And you're thinking, Jimmy, you're crazy. No, listen to me. I wrote about this in my book. Values such as discipline and determination. Ethics and character, faith. Hold on.
It's me. In that chair or what? Or is it easier just?
Okay, so personalization. You take transaction and relationship and smash them together.
Uh-huh.
New world, podcasting. New world, transcendence plus old world values.
Okay.
See, my granddad has his business. He taught me old world values.
Uh-huh.
And so that's how I wrote my book, The Winning Personality, a values-based approach to entrepreneurship in this economy. And so it's not an either or. It is also all, it's two for the price of one.
Okay.
Now I hope you enjoy listening to Empower Your Pattern 2.0. If you like what you hear, please subscribe and become a citizen of Pattern Realm. This is Jimmy Hendrix saying until next time, don't just sit there and take it. Build your dreams so you can take it. Do what others don't so you can be what others won't. Do what others don't so you can have what others can. Choose, act, and pursue happiness. And God bless you. Take care.